Defenestrations of Prague. The defenestrations of Prague were two incidents in the history of Bohemia in which multiple people were defenestrated. The first occurred in 1419, and the second in 1618, although the term defenestration of Prague more commonly refers to the second. Each helped to trigger a prolonged religious conflict inside Bohemia or beyond. The first defenestration of Prague involved the killing of seven members of the city council by a crowd of Czech Hussites on July 30, 1419. Jan Zelivsky, a Hussite priest at the Church of the Virgin Mary of the Snows, led his congregation on a procession through the streets of Prague to the new town hall on Charles Square. The town council members had refused to exchange their Hussite prisoners. While they were marching, a stone was thrown at Zelivsky from the window of the town hall and allegedly hit him. This enraged the mob and they stormed the town hall. Once inside the hall, the group defenestrated the judge, the burgomaster, and several members of the town council. They were all killed by the fall. King Wenceslaus IV of Bohemia, upon hearing this news, was stunned and died shortly after, supposedly due to the shock. The procession was a result of the growing discontent at the contemporary direction of the church and the inequality between the peasants, the church's prelates, and the nobility. This discontent combined with rising feelings of nationalism increased the influence of preachers such as Jan Zelivsky, influenced by John Wycliffe, who saw the state of the Catholic Church as corrupt. These preachers urged their congregations to action, including taking up arms, to combat these perceived transgressions. The first defenestration was thus the turning point between talk and action leading to the prolonged Hussite Wars. The wars broke out shortly afterward and lasted until 1436. The second defenestration of Prague precipitated the Thirty Years' War. In 1555, the Peace of Augsburg had settled religious disputes in the Holy Roman Empire by enshrining the principle of cuius regio, eius religio, allowing a prince to determine the religion of his subjects. The Kingdom of Bohemia since 1526 had been governed by Habsburg kings, who did not force their Catholic religion on their largely Protestant subjects. In 1609, Rudolf II, Holy Roman Emperor and King of Bohemia, increased Protestant rights. He was increasingly viewed as unfit to govern, and other members of the Habsburg dynasty declared his younger brother, Matthias, to be family head in 1606. Matthias began to gradually wrest territory from Rudolf, beginning with Hungary. In 1609, to strengthen his hold on Bohemia, Rudolf issued the Letter of Majesty, which granted Bohemia's largely Protestant estates the right to freely exercise their religion, essentially setting up a Protestant Bohemian state church controlled by the estates, dominated by the towns and rural nobility. Upon Rudolf's death, Matthias succeeded in the rule of Bohemia and extended his offer of more legal and religious concessions to Bohemia, relying mostly on the advice of his chancellor, Bishop Melchior Kölzl. Conflict was precipitated by two factors. Matthias, already aging and without children, made his cousin Ferdinand of Styria his heir and had him elected king in 1617. Ferdinand was a proponent of the Catholic Counter-Reformation and not likely to be well disposed to Protestantism or Bohemian freedoms. Bohemian Protestants opposed the royal government as they interpreted the Letter of Majesty to extend not only to the land controlled by the nobility or self-governing towns but also to the king's own lands. Whereas Matthias and Kölzl were prepared to appease these demands, Ferdinand was not. In 1618 he forced the emperor to order the cessation of construction of some Protestant chapels on royal land. When the Bohemian estates protested against this order, Ferdinand had their assembly dissolved. On May 23, 1618, four Catholic lords regent, Count Yaroslav Borzita of Martinice, Count Wilhelm Slavata of Chlum, Adam II von Sternberg, and Matthew Leopold Pope Lobkowitz, arrived at the Bohemian Chancellery at 8:30 a.m. After preparing the meeting hall, members of the dissolved assembly of the three main Protestant estates gathered at 9 a.m., led by Count Thurn, who had been deprived of his post as Castellan of Karlstadt by the emperor. The Protestant lords' agenda was to clarify whether the four regents present were responsible for persuading the emperor to order the cessation of Protestant church construction on royal lands. According to Martinice himself, before the regents gave any answer, they requested that the Protestants give them the opportunity to confer with their superior, Adam von Waldstein, who was not present. If they were given the opportunity, the Protestants were to receive an official answer to their grievance by the next Friday. The Protestant lords, however, demanded an immediate answer. Two regents, Adam II von Sternberg and Matthew Leopold Pope Lobkowitz, were declared innocent by the Protestant estate holders, deemed to be too pious to have any responsibility in the preparation of the emperor's letter. They were removed from the room. Before leaving, Adam II von Sternberg made it clear that they did not advise anything that was contrary to the letter of majesty. This left Count Wilhelm Slavatich Lum and Count Jaroslav Borzita of Martinice, both known Catholic hardliners, and Philip Fabricius, the secretary to the regents. They eventually acknowledged responsibility for the letter and, presuming they would only be arrested, welcomed any punishment the Protestants had planned. Count von Thurn turned to both Martinice and Slavata and said, "You are enemies of us and of our religion, have desired to deprive us of our letter of majesty, have horribly plagued your Protestant subjects, and have tried to force them to adopt your religion against their wills or have had them expelled for this reason." Then to the crowd of Protestants, he continued, "Were we to keep these men alive, then we would lose the letter of majesty in our religion. For there can be no justice to be gained for more by them." Shortly thereafter, the two regents and their secretary were defenestrated, but they survived the fall from the third floor. Catholics maintained the men were saved by angels or by the intercession of the Virgin Mary, who caught them. Later Protestant pamphleteers asserted that they survived due to falling onto a dung heap, a story unknown to contemporaries and probably coined in response to divine intervention claims. Philip Fabricius was later ennobled by the emperor and granted the title Baron von Hohenfels. Immediately after the defenestration, the Protestant estates and Catholic Habsburgs started gathering allies for war. After the death of Matthias in 1619, Ferdinand II was elected Holy Roman Emperor. At the same time, the Bohemian estates deposed him as King of Bohemia and replaced him with Frederick V, Elector Palatine, a leading Calvinist and son-in-law of the Protestant James VI, King of Scotland, England, and Ireland. Because they deposed a properly chosen king, the Protestants could not gather the international support they needed for war. Just 2 years after the defenestration, Ferdinand and the Catholics regained power in the Battle of White Mountain on November 8, 1620. This became known as the first battle in the Thirty Years' War. There was plundering and pillaging in Prague for weeks following the battle. Several months later, 27 nobles and citizens were tortured and executed in the Old Town Square. 12 of their heads were impaled on iron hooks and hung from the bridge tower as a warning. This contributed to the resentment that gave rise to the Thirty Years' War. More events of defenestration have occurred in Prague during its history, but they are not usually called defenestrations of Prague. A defenestration happened on September 24, 1483, when a violent overthrow of the municipal governments of the old and new towns ended with throwing the old town Port Reeve and the bodies of 7 killed aldermen out of the windows of the respective town halls. Sometimes, the name the Third Defenestration of Prague is used, although it has no standard meaning. For example, it has been used to describe the death of Jan Masaryk, who was found below the bathroom window of the building of the Czechoslovak Ministry of Foreign Affairs on March 10, 1948. The official report listed the death as a suicide. However, it was widely believed he was murdered, either by the nascent communist government in which he served as a nonpartisan foreign minister, or by the Soviet secret services. A Prague police report in 2004 concluded after forensic research that Masaryk had indeed been defenestrated to his death. This report was seemingly corroborated in 2006 when a Russian journalist said that his mother knew the Russian intelligence officer who defenestrated Masaryk. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.